Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. It's pretty easy. Now your turn. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar.
Good work.
Now Ingemar Johansson was no Ollie. He was no Rocky Marciano. He was no Sugar Ray. But the hammer of Thor was in his right fist, and with it he won the world championship. Now Floyd Patterson, he made a smart, steady climb to the heavyweight title and defended four times. But he never got the love that Ingemar did, even though he was a good, clean American kid.
Here we go.
Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar was pretty, but ladies never were far. He enjoyed the attention, the nightlife, the bars. The paper said this party boy didn't hardly even train. Still, the great white hope, he was showered in fame. Meanwhile, Floyd was like a rat in the gym. No liquor, no women, no earthly sin. From the hard streets of Brooklyn, he swore he'd never go back. The sweat poured like rain as he worked the big sack. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Now Ingemar was awkward, he had long skinny legs, a great big neck like a 10-gallon keg. He could leap like a lizard at his prey with a hook. A powerful left that would leave him flat as a book. While Ingemar had a much more conservative style, patience was his weapon, his reputation guile. He had a long left jab, kept his opponents at bay. His other glove was hidden where his true power lay. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Bell rang, the two men went toe to toe. Floyd was surprised, Ingemar got in for a blow. But he wasn't so impressed, thought this fight was a lark. He could outbox this white boy like a walk in the park. Round one and round two, it was all Floyd's fight. The 5-1 odds seemed just about right. But in a split moment, his glove, it dropped from his chin. It was Ingemar's chance to send Thor's hammer in. When the lights went out, Floyd dropped to the ground. 6 times he got up, but 7 times knocked down. The third round TKO from that thunderous right. The ref had no choice but to stop the fight. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar And Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Ingemar could have dodged Floyd and made some serious dough fighting chumps back in Europe. Take on any Jack or Joe, but he gave Floyd a rematch, though he was rolling the dice. He knew Floyd would not make the same mistake twice. Now there was no trash talking between these two men. Outside the ring they became best of friends. The respect that they shared was one few ever see. Only with the gloves will they fierce enemies. Now the next fight was brutal. Anyone could see that. That time each man found himself flat on the mat. But Floyd fought smart and he paced himself right. And a fifth round knockout spell at the end of this fight. His flipping Molly bleeding, his leg quivering. Heartbreaking emotion, it filled up the ring. There was no celebration, Floyd ran to his side. Knelt down by his friend, tears filled up his eyes. Ingemar and Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar, Ingemar and Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar. Now Ingemar and Floyd remained dearest of friends, till they both were old and feeble and frail in the end. Brothers in blood, in pain and in sweat. The greatest opponent the man ever met. They hated the hurt they inflicted on men. They did love their jobs and their job was to win. The pain and the blood was just something to sell. And Ingemar and Floyd, they did their jobs well. Last time, Ingemar and Floyd, Floyd and Ingemar, Ingemar and